Math 1332, Chapter 2, Set Theory, Section 2.2, Subsets and Set Operations, Video 3, The Empty Set as a Subset. In the previous video, we defined sets and subsets, and we had a way to determine is one set a subset of another by passing judgment on each of its elements. Recall that what it means for one set to be a subset of another is if every element in the first set also belongs to the second set. So you can go one element at a time in the first set and ask it, do you belong to the other set? Do you belong to the other set? Do you belong to the other set? And if everybody says yes, then you are a subset. There's another way to think about being a subset by asking what it means to not be a subset. And we'll talk about that as we go through some of these. All right, so let's start out with a specific set in mind. We are supposing that our set is very simple. Set A contains the numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the question is simply, which of the following are subsets of A? Notice I didn't say proper subset, just subsets. All right, let's start with 1 and 3, the set containing 1 and 3. To answer the question, are you a subset of A, we simply have to look at each of its elements and ask it a question. Element number 1, do you belong in A? The answer is yes, so we'll put a check over it. Element 3, do you belong to A? Yes, it does, it's right there. So he's okay. Since every element of this set belongs to A, that means that this set is a subset of A. We'll go ahead and write that. All right, let's check the next one, the set containing 2, 4, and 6. And it may be obvious to you. So think about it. In fact, I invite you to pause the video and see if you can pass judgment on all of these. And if it's a subset, why? And if it's not a subset, why is it not? You'll notice this one down here is the empty set. That was on purpose. We'll talk about it in a moment. So pause the video and see if you can determine which of these are subsets, or even proper subsets, if you will. All right, hopefully you paused the video and took a shot at it. If I talk too fast, then I'll give you a chance to pause. So go ahead and hit the pot. Okay. Just being goofy. All right, so let's take a look at the next one. The set containing 2, 4, and 6. Is this a subset of A? It should be a pretty immediate no because there's one element that doesn't belong to A. But if you were to just pass judgment on all of them, 2 is in A, so it's okay. That's a check mark. 4 is in A, so it's okay. But 6 is not in A, so he's not okay. He gets an X. And it only takes one element to break it being a subset. So how could we write that this is not a subset of A? I haven't introduced the notation to you yet, but I bet you can figure it out. To show that this is not a subset of A, we could write it like this. Very standard way of saying not, put a slash through something. It's not a proper subset either because you have to be a subset before you're a proper subset. Speaking of which, let's take a look at the next one. The set containing 1, 2, 3, and 4. Is that a subset of A? Well, it should be pretty obvious that these are the same sets. And we did say in the previous video that every set is a subset of itself. If you wanted to pass judgment on the elements, it wouldn't take that long. Is 1 in A? Yes. Is 2 in A? Yes. Is 3 in A? Yes. Is 4 in A? Yes. Since every element of the set is inside of A, that means that it is a subset. But it's also worth noting that it's not a proper subset. Because to be a proper subset, you must be a subset and not equal. This one is not a proper subset because it is equal. Okay? Let's be a little bit more efficient on this last one, or this next one. Is this a subset of A? And if it's not, why not? It's not a subset of A because there's a bad element. Who's the bad element? The bad element is 5. Excuse me. The bad element is 5. 5 is not inside of A, And so we cannot say that every element is also an element of A. That means that it is not a subset. Everything in this must belong to A, and it doesn't. What about the singleton set, the set containing one? Well, that's easy to pass judgment on. You only have to check one element. Well, is one an A? Yes. Every element belongs to A, which means it is a subset. And we could even say it's proper subset, as we could back up here. There's only one subset that would be a subset, but not a proper subset, and that's when you're talking about the whole set itself. Otherwise, every set is both a subset and a proper subset with that one exception. All right, so now let's get down to the whole reason that we're having this discussion. The last set we're talking about is the empty set. Is that a subset of A? Well, how do you get to be a subset of A? Every element of U must belong to A. Does every element of the empty set belong to A? And you might be thinking, well, that's kind of a trick question because there's no elements in the empty set to begin with. So how can we begin to pass judgment on its elements? All right, well, let me flip the script and ask you, is it not a subset? And if you're thinking, well, that's the same question, then not quite, because I want to go back to this one. Why was the set containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 not a subset of A? The first four numbers were all in A. These were all in A. Oops, excuse me. These were all in A. So why was it a subset? Because it was a bad number. The bad number was 5. The reason it's not a subset is because we found an element that didn't belong to A. So if we look at it from a reverse perspective, you're not a subset if I can find an element in you that isn't part of the larger set. So this current example that I'm sitting on right now is not a subset because I found a bad element. I found an element that did not belong to A. Can you find an element here that does not belong to A? You can't. It has no elements, so there can't be any bad elements. So really, it's not an issue of are all the elements good? It's an issue of is there a bad element, an element that doesn't belong to the larger set. So in a backwards sort of way, the empty set is a subset of A. And the reason it's a subset is because we can't find an element that convinces us otherwise. Over here, the 5 is why we said it's not a subset. Up here on the second example, the 6 is why we said it's not a subset. But down here, we can't find an element that says you're not a subset. So by default, the empty set is a subset of A. And in this case, it's also a proper subset because A and the empty set are not equal. So what does this mean? What do I want you to know? Well, here's what I want you to know. The empty set is a subset of any set, including itself. So another way of saying this is for any set A, and I'm going to draw this, for any set A, the empty set is a subset of A. It's almost by default. When we get into the next chapter about logic, we'll take another look at this and show you why it has to be true, that the empty set is a subset of every element, subset of every other set, including itself. But the empty set is a proper subset of every set except, remember, proper means you're a subset and not equal. So the only way you can't be a proper subset if you're a subset is if you're equal to. So the empty set is a proper set of every set except itself. So in other words, for any non-empty set A, we can say that the empty set is a proper subset of it, but the empty set is not a proper subset of itself, because you have to be not equal to be proper subsets, and the empty set is clearly empty to itself. I think the concept of subset is pretty straightforward, but when it comes to the empty set, it might not be so intuitive. Just remember, the empty set is a subset of everything, and it's a proper subset of everything except itself.